Glad I got to use her today. My girl here.
You really like that girl.
What's not to like?
It's just a gun.
That's where you're wrong. This is Charlotte. She's as faithful as a starving hound when you got a bone in your pocket.
How do you run this place with just one cow?
Used to have more. They get hungry too. Or sick. Got your doctor friend here now, though.
You guys must trade for a lot of fuel to keep the generators running, right?
People get hungry, and a few loaves of bread fetch a high price. Y'all are luckier on this side of the deal now.
You guys are pretty out in the sticks here.
Hard to find.
You get many visitors?
Not anymore. Bandits, of course. Used to get these school kids on tours back before the dead time.
I'm gonna go wait for supper then.
It'll be a good one.
All fixed. That should make everyone happy. Toolbox. I'm just gonna borrow this for a second. I'm glad Andy knows how to fix this if something goes wrong, but clueless about this stuff. Doesn't look very safe, but I guess that's the point.
Hey, so what happened at the camp? Did you guys find any more of those guys that hurt Mark?
We found a tent and some boxes. Nothing really useful.
Seriously? No food?
Jesus.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something.
But you told him to mind his own goddamn business, right? We are guests here. We don't need to be overstaying our welcome more than we already are.
The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he oughta.
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
Thanks.
Yep.
How do you like that cow, Clint?
She's pretty.
She looks skinny. Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I don't think so, Clem. Not the way the world is now. I don't think I could do that.
Oh. Maybe when the world gets better, then.
Maybe.
Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead. Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like manure.
What's manure?
Duty.
Kids?
In the hay.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay.
Empty. Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul. It's a feeding trough.
Found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look, that guy with Katya. What's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second. You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock. Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal in those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor. What'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee. You know how to pick a lock, right?
No! Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know, urban?
Oh, you are not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus, man, I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry. What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Just checking out the barn here. Never been to a dairy farm before.
Just don't roam around without me or Danny. The farm can be a dangerous place. You know, the bandits and all. Sorry about your friend. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc.
I picked up something I think could help with the lock.
All right. Good to hear.
Any thoughts on how to distract Andy?
I don't know, man. Just look for something outside of the barn. We need him out of here.
So, how does a woman like yourself run this whole place?
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
What's going on, Lee? Did something happen?
Nothing. Everything's fine. It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
Does he treat you like that too?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
After what Kenny told me, I'm starting to think they may be trying to hide something.
You two are just asking for trouble. But if you insist on wandering around, I'd be careful, Lee.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Watch yourself, Lee.
We'll finish talking later.
You been getting along with Larry?
He's just a big old sweetheart, ain't he?
Don't know if I would have used those words exactly.
Don't judge, honey. This world is bringing out the worst in people. But if you really look, you'll catch a glimpse of humanity every now and then.
How's Mark doing in there?
Best patient I ever had. Oh, my boys get so much as a scratch and start hollering. He could definitely teach them a thing or two about being tough.
I'd still like to check on him.
You're gonna have to trust me on this, Lee. I've helped stitch my share of wounds. I know what I'm talking about.
We ran into some trouble out there.
I was just glad you two weren't hurt. Those bandits just don't know when to quit. But my boys, they can hold their own.
Why did you make a deal with those people?
We got a thread of humanity left, Lee. We can do more good without them in our hair by placating them. So that's what we do.
So, what do y'all keep in the barn back there? Besides cows, I mean.
Well, someone's getting a little curious, aren't they?
I don't mean to pry.
It's nothing interesting, I can promise you that much. Just some odds and ends. Takes a lot to run a farm, you know.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Kinda peaceful out here, ain't it? Enjoy it while you can. You'll probably start hearing those monsters frying against the fence before too long.
Is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
Guess I'm gonna need a screwdriver for this. Too tight for my bare hands.
Again?
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! 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 Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Dinner time.
Why was there so much blood in there?
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house. So you see, nothing to worry about.
Oh, Brenda,
biscuits?
You
wow.
are an angel.
Oh,
excuse
boy.
The mess. We had to block the back door after a walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. I'll go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now, don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Mind if I wash my hands first?
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
Gauze pads. I could use a shave. Some kind of lotion. Books, cookbooks, nothing out of the ordinary here. Where the hell is Mark? Thought Brenda said he was up here resting. Feels like there's a storm coming. Is that blood? So much morphine for. Musty as hell. Ugh, what is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff? Huh, where's that cord going? The hell? candles. Smart.
Jesus, man. Did you find something?
Aw, oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into you?
He just had a start.
He could use some goddamn manners.
Mark is upstairs with his fucking legs cut off. You're eating him.
That's crazy.
The hell?
You're scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. It's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that!
Go upstairs and look. You'll find a guy with both of his legs hacked off. This is a dairy, not a ranch. Think about it!
It's true.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boys. Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Just let us go.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways, one way or another.
Like y'all.
Kenny, get your gun!
Kenny, no!
Nobody's going anywhere!
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking black
Put
fuck.
Your guns down! We're walking out
don't
of here!
Don't go near my fucking family!
I don't want to die. Mommy, what did I eat?
Everyone, everything will be okay!
Lee? Lee?
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!